sensibility, honesty, and a sense of humor. Words commonly used to describe legendary artist Huang Yongyu's work. At an exhibition at the National Museum of Modern Chinese Literature, visitors can admire his work as well as the inner world of the artist. Illustrations by Huang Yongyu have been shown together with excerpts of his poems, along with some of his original manuscripts. All of them are from his latest poetry collection, 见笑集, or a collection of things that incur ridicule, which contains more than 150 poems. With his artistic career spanning over half a century, Huang always manages to convey the deep meaning of life in a light and natural way. He illustrated each poem in the book in just 2 weeks.
我哪一路子就是没有想来不及想我忘了画眼睛中间那个梁后来大概谁补上眼睛框过中间那个梁本来没有的我忘后来发现没画最近谁补上了黄老
Being a prolific writer of poems, fiction, and prose, Huang Yongyu has explored various forms of art, such as woodcut prints and traditional paintings. He's known as a generation of ghost talents. Some of his famous works include Spring Tide and Ashima, which established his position in the art world. With what he calls an aroma of soil, his woodcut prints indicate his profound insights into people, life, and the world around him. At the age of 98, Huang's latest ambition is to hold a new exhibition when he is 100 years old.
我从事艺术几十年，取得唯一经验，就是不要倚老卖老。 天老爷保佑，看看我能不能熬到100岁，还差那么一年多一点点。我开个新作品展览。Good
is how Huang Yongyu describes his new exhibition.
好，好，比他好。现在好在哪儿啊？您觉得？好在有头脑。 还有自己觉得比以前画得好，我画大概是两种，一种认真细致的一种画，另外一种想法，我这个想法特别不能让人看到，因为很容易模仿。我不是说我有什么理想意志，要把它画得不是这个意思。 也不能大动作了，就画小动作，画的大点就是纸大点慢一点，时间长一点，没有什么，要画的就认真的努力吧，即使不好的话也努力的话，我的计划，现在是。
Born in 1924 in central China's Hunan province, Huang has had a lengthy artistic career. He left his hometown of Fenghuang in his teens. Soon after the year 1937, Huang Yongyu started his personal journey. Huang studied literature and art on his own, taking on a variety of jobs and learning all kinds of artistic skills along the way. At the age of 28, Huang became a professor at the Central Academy of Fine Arts, the leading fine arts academy in China. He also designed the first monkey stamp at the age of 56. Since 1980, China has released stamps with one of the 12 zodiac animals before every spring festival. In the 1990s, Huang Yongyu went to Europe, visiting cities like Paris and Florence, depicting all kinds of people and scenery along the way. In 2007, 83-year-old Huang Yongyu appeared on the cover of the fashion magazine Mr. Fashion, the oldest model to appear on the cover in the magazine's history. Huang's rich life experience enables him to have a deep understanding of life, which he writes about in his books. On his 98th birthday, Huang Yongyu announced the launch of a new 480,000-word book, Day Reading. The third part of his long autobiographical novel, A Wanderer from the Carefree River.
不写的可惜了，别人就忘了。不是我自己说的话，可惜。用这种角度进入这么一个大时代，可惜了。 因为我不光在写我，写当时的一个大时代，我也不能吹牛，我说我以后一定能写能活，不要紧，你能够活到一百二，你这样的话，哄孩子都不行，是吧？安慰我不实际，是吧？我估计。 植物人变成植物人的可能性不太多，脑子还比较顽固，但是生命不让你继续下去，这没有什么办法。活着要工作，每一样工作你做你自己的工作，你应该认真的工作。
他这辈子住寄住在童话这个地，他谁都不想。他不是故意，从未让谁跑进过。不是驴没人给掏过脚头，不是狼他孑然一身，不是喜鹊没抱过喜宴，不是乌鸦没唱过丧歌。张喜子选的什么都不像的动物，鸭嘴兽，鸭子嘴巴，水陆两栖，全身毛，卵生。
Zhang Xuzi is the protagonist in Huang's book, A Wanderer from the Carefree River, who looks nothing like a platypus. The character mirrors Huang Yongyu himself.
骨骼称之什么怎么？你读过多少书啊？你说你是工人阶级，更谈不上。军人也不是，什么都不是。干活就是，人家愿意用、愿意看、愿意听，就好了，就不错了。画画有什么了不起？你要想。 想出一些新鲜主意，要能做得到，你想到了也还能做得到，啊，还要小心慢慢的把它做出来，不就是这样？老话同样的也不行，不做重复的事，艺术家一辈子不要重复。
同样的题材也要不断的创新，啊！我看您鸭嘴兽你也画过，虽然画的不多，但是画的动物很多呀，对吧？像猴，大家也都非常知名了；猫头鹰你也画过，老鼠你也画过不少。
哎，对。
那您觉得这些动物里边，您觉得哪个动物最能代表您？
代表我，老鼠还是老鼠。
还老鼠，
还是老鼠，老鼠知足，彼得知足，莫不是？
嗯，
那也追了他就会躲会跑，那倒霉了就碰到猫，要是没有猫，这日子挺好过的。
嗯。
Although in his 90s, he still maintains a child's mind. Experiencing ups and downs in life, Huang keeps a sincere heart and always finds something to laugh about in life's hardships.
他就说，不欣赏自己摔倒的地方，爬起来就往前走，不要哀叹这个坑。有的人是一辈子记得那个坑不走了，再骂那个坑，摔一跤赶快爬起来往前走。一个人呢，你要看这个人有没有意思，就看他对待自己讲不讲自己的笑话。要说谎可费的力气啊，可真的可大了。你看别人在说谎，你看了你就觉得好笑，掩盖
啊，
要用很多方法来掩盖，掩盖费的力气比诚实多多了。我们什么事情都是这样，诚实是简单的，掩盖要费很大的力气。所以我一辈子的事不就是这样？你不行就不行，行就行，是很简单的事。
As for the young people, Huang Yongyu encourages them to read more instead of indulging themselves in smartphones. In his words, reading is much better than doing trivial things.
多看书，不要老看电视、手机，多看书才有知识。书同手机不一样，手机是你帮他帮你想，书是从他那里得到知识，有基础。要多看书是真是厉害。你比如说，跑万米不是人，他有一个目标。跑万米的时候很难看，是吧？别人真的这个人这样那样。甚至连样子他都要骗人，别理他，继续的跑。人有很多时间浪费在忍不住要跟别人争论。你想一想，犯得着吗？花时间去吵去闹，把这个时间来看书多好。
我看你写那个比我老的老头，对吧？里面像钱钟书先生，包括您的这个表叔沈从文先生，对吧？里边写到很多的朋友，我记得您当时还提到说，就张乐平先生。我看您怀念他的时候，还特别提到说，年轻人容易错过老人。是指的错过老人的什么呢？
错过给他接近，学习他身上的某种东西。是啊，因为每一个老人家有每一点可爱可敬的东西，是不是？你说常常错过了，我有机会有时间，为什么不去看看他了？是吧？或者从他那里会得到很多教育，是吧？他也需要年轻朋友的。
In Huang Yongyu's artwork, people can feel the weight of time, but told in an easy and humorous way. In his eyes, the world is still vigorous and full of life. His way of language is humorous, but deep in meaning.
你不笑怎么办呢？这个笑这个东西是勉，有的时候是勉强。有的时候想那个笑话，再碰到个事情， 碰着了，是一个巧合。也会笑。一个国王早上有很多大臣，国王是一个有兴趣的国王，他今天来问一下，谁怕老婆？大家不说话。那好，怕老婆的站这边，不怕的在那边。大家都过来了，只有一个老头不过去。哎呀，那你真不简单，你不怕老婆？老婆交代过，人多的地方别去。
您存了一箩筐一箩筐的笑话，我看您书里经常有各种各样的笑话。您觉得现在最真实的快乐是什么？
大家都过正常的生活了，那就快乐了。啊，少一些忧愁。我画了一张画。画我们这个太阳城的夜景，满天星。我下面写了这，题目叫做《今夜》，希望所有的人都是像这样的过的今夜。今晚全世界人都这样的，这么的甜美，这么的。年轻，愿上天给人家每个人都有美好的经验，天天如此，月月如此，年年如此，十年如此，百年如此。告诉子孙们，人应该拥有如今夜之权利，过宁心和今夜如今夜之日子，这幅留在人手，我愿他能平安地保存下来，欣赏他，试着猜想作者和观众当年在这幅画前的笑容和笑声。比如考古学家对未来的某一天有经验的观众说，这幅画是个90多岁近100岁的老头画的，水平虽然算不得高，留到至今起码能给后人一点欢喜，告诉我们那时候人是如何打发日子的。
Huang Yongyu's life is more than worry-free. Despite sorrow and suffering in his early years, he still keeps a positive attitude towards life and is not even scared of death.
我还记得咱们看您那个画展的时候，诗集里边有一首诗是假如我活到100岁，那个是您56岁的时候，1980年的时候写的。哦，那您那个时候有没有想过自己真的活到100岁？
没有，我那时候想活到2000年都不敢想。
世纪之交。
都不敢想。我对死我是一点也不畏惧，而且我不希望留下什么骨灰啊，什么进什么祠堂啊，不需要。所以我开玩笑，我这死了之后先搁着我一下，看我笑不笑。我上过了常熟的描述，我是一个不惹是非的老头。我曾经历过最大的震动和呼唤，我最大的满足是不被人唾骂，不被人诅咒。我用我自己混得太久，我觉得还是做我自己的。
A man in his 90s, but still with a childlike innocence. This is what people have found in Huang Yongyu, a seasoned artist with a child's heart. 吕琼 CG 体验。